Hey guys, this is Royden from Gadgets360 and today I'm going to be showing you a device that is more expensive than quite literally anything I currently own. I am of course talking about the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip. Now, I was quite excited to see this smartphone when I first used it at the launch event back in February, and now that I've spent about a week living with the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip, it is time to see if this smartphone is actually worth considering if you want to buy it, or if my initial interest was just a brief fling. Now, before we go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also hit that bell icon so you're the first to know whenever we push out a new video. Let's face it, this isn't a phone for the average smartphone buyer. It costs about 1,16,000 rupees, so while I have this phone with me, I'm gonna quickly show you what's in the box. Since this is a foldable, there are some ground rules you need to follow so you don't accidentally damage it. The set of care instructions come printed right on the plastic sleeve covering the phone so you don't miss it when you unbox it. Samsung is promoting the new mirror gold finish of the Galaxy Z Flip, which quite frankly is a bit too flashy for me. And there is a case included in the box, but it's a clear case with gold accents, so it doesn't really do much to hide the bling. This is one of the only foldable phones to ship with an ultra-thin glass, however, it is still pretty fragile. Now, the first warning on the wrapper specifically mentions not to press the screen with any object, even your fingernail, as it could puncture the display. Well, I thought I'd give it a mini test myself. A quick warning, guys, do not try this at home. Now, I obviously didn't set out to destroy the phone, but I was curious to see if even slight pressure from a fingernail was enough to make a dent. Sure enough, it actually does. Now, the dent went away after a while since it was mostly superficial, but any more pressure and it could have resulted in a permanent mark, possibly even ruining that portion of the display. Word to the wise, don't go poking at the Z Flip's display. Now, the Galaxy Z Flip is not dust or water resistant, so you need to be extra careful handling it, especially in the rains. Other than that, the Galaxy Z Flip has exceptional build quality. Everything from the hinge to the metal frame to the glass back of the two halves feel very premium. If there was ever a phone you buy for pure flaunt value, then the gold version of the Galaxy Z Flip would be among the top on that list. After setting it up with my SIM card in the phone, I'll admit, I did spend the next hour or so simply opening and closing the phone every chance I got, simply because of how cool it felt. I mean, when was the last time you were able to do this to a smartphone? The Galaxy Z Flip is currently the only phone commercially available to use ultra-thin glass, while the rest like the Motorola Razr 2019 and even the Galaxy Fold are still using a plastic layer for protection. The spring-loaded hinge feels robust and firmly clamps the Galaxy Z Flip shut or keeps it wide open depending on your action. I also love how the hinge hides away when opened. One of the main perks of having a folding smartphone is the convenience factor. Folded up, it's literally half the size of today's average smartphone, which means it's super easy to carry around. Now, when folded, it looks like a little business card case in your hand, and that square shape definitely takes a bit of getting used to. It's a little chunky in its folded state, but the total weight is still a very acceptable 183 grams. Besides the compact size, the Galaxy Z Flip can be used with the display half open, which Samsung calls flex mode. Now, at the moment, this works for a limited number of apps only. For instance, YouTube fills up the upper portion of the display with the video and pushes everything else to the bottom. This also works in the gallery and also the camera apps. The beauty of this mode is that you don't need to have a phone stand, as the bottom section of the Z Flip itself becomes a stand. Now, I use it to take some long exposure shots without a tripod or even set a 10-second timer without having to worry about where I'm going to rest the phone. And trust me guys, it's really cool. Now, behind all these cool tricks lies a true blue flagship smartphone. The Galaxy Z Flip uses a Snapdragon 855 Plus chip, which is still plenty powerful even a year later. It's only available in one configuration with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of internal storage. The main 6.7-inch display has a Full HD Plus resolution and a standard 60Hz refresh rate. Colors look vivid and brightness level is very good. Now, there is a mild crease where the display folds and you can feel the small dip with your finger, but after a few days it wasn't really an issue. Now, most videos are letterboxed with thick black bars on the left and right of the video, which is another thing to get used to for such a form factor. You can zoom in to fill up most or all of the display, but at the cost of heavily cropping the frame on the top and bottom. However, the one feature I sorely missed are stereo speakers on the Z Flip. Now, the bottom firing one gets pretty loud, but I did miss having proper dual channel sound. The Galaxy Z Flip has a side-mounted capacitive fingerprint sensor in the power button. It works well when needed, although I didn't end up using it much as face unlock kicks in the moment you unfold it. Using the Galaxy Z Flip for calls and messaging has been great. It's surprisingly not too top-heavy when texting, and the earpiece has good clarity for voice calls. Coming to the cameras, I found them to be pretty good. These consist of dual 12-megapixel sensors on the back and a 10-megapixel selfie camera in the hole punch cutout. Situated next to the rear cameras is a 1.05-inch OLED touch display, which is used to show basic information and alerts. Now, my biggest problem with it though is that it's too small and not very responsive to be of much use. The double tap to wake gesture doesn't work well all the time, and even swiping between the three panels of information feels like an effort. Samsung should have really used a larger panel to make it more functional. The Samsung Galaxy Z Flip costs about 1,16,000 rupees right now, which is a lot, but I don't think it's crazy expensive considering the uniqueness of it. Would I recommend the Z Flip? Well, if you're willing to make slight changes in your smartphone usage habits and live with a certain level of anxiety all the time, then you should be plenty happy with it. Unfortunately, I cannot comment on how well it'll hold up after, say, 6 months or so, but if you follow Samsung's care instructions diligently, then it should last you long enough till your next upgrade. Personally, I'm super pumped for a foldable smartphone future. Now, other than a few restrictions with the Galaxy Z Flip, it's pretty much like using any flagship Samsung smartphone. However, having said that, I will wait for the next version, and I'm hoping Samsung puts a larger and a more useful outer display on the next version of the Z Flip. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching, and for all things tech, log on to gadgets360.com.